Do you remember, it was, I think, 2 years ago when in Washington, or I don't know, remember when, in Connecticut.
Oh, in right, in Newtown, Connecticut at the school.
A lot of children, yes.
That was last December, 20 children and 6 adults at the Sandy Hook Elementary School in Newtown, Connecticut.
Yes, when I heard this news, I was very sad. I even cried a little, and all Russia was in shock when this news, I don't know, when we hear this news, it was very terrible. I think United States has to understand why people becoming mad, and your government has to do something for protecting usual people who just wanted to work and grow the children and live a usual life in the United States.
Now, Andrei, what about in Russia? What are the laws about owning a gun in Russia?
It is kind of difficult for Russian people to buy weapons, because for buying weapons, you have to go to police statement and to write some paper there. Then you have to go to the hospital, and you have special paper that you're not crazy or mad. And for example, if you buy a rifle for hunting, you have, or even pistol or gun, you have to have special box in your home, metal box to put there. And for example, when you are buying hunting rifle, you have divided it into pieces. I don't know how to say it.
Oh, to break it down, to disassemble it.
Yes, and you can take it together in the city. You can do it only when you're in the forest. You can have the whole rifle in the city. It is law. And for example, if you are living with neighbors, you have to tell them that you buy a weapon, and they have to agree that you have a weapon. It is kind of difficult to have.
You're saying that your neighbors have to know, or do the neighbors have to approve, or do they just have to know that you have it?
Yes. No. They have to approve that they are not against that you have a weapon.
This is Amir Khalouf. I'm from Kuwait. I'm a teacher of English.
Excellent. Glad to have you.
Are you originally from Kuwait or where?
I'm from Syria.
From Syria.
So you have a lot to talk to us about, I'm sure. Our topic this week is about the Navy Yard shooting, but we'd also like to talk to you about Syria. Why don't we start out with the fact that a man with a gun walked into the Navy Yard in Washington and shot 12 people.
And he worked there. I mean, he was a contract employee who...
I want to know first, is he a soldier or what?
He was a contractor.
He had been in the Navy. He was a former sailor and then was in the Navy Reserves and left the Navy and then got a job, still had his security clearance to work, worked for a company that then... He, you know, had him work on computers at that Navy Yard, and so he had a right, you know, or that's where he worked, and then he went and you know, killed 12 people and then died in a shootout with the police. So they're still trying to figure out what.
Why?
He had a history of mental health problems and.
Okay, as I saw on TV news that the cause. For this massacre, I think that was a mental problem with that man.
But beyond that, Amir, beyond the cause?
Isn't that a terrorist action?
I mean, it sounds like the we haven't heard anything so far to suggest that it was terrorism related. What we're hearing is the reports that he would hear voices in his head and that he had a history of encounters with the police, and it was he had been
interesting though that you use the word terrorism. What do you consider a terrorist attack? Because there may be a discrepancy in our definition.
as I want to say, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Any killing is terrorism, okay? Because you are terrifying other people. So it's terrorism, okay? But in our days, okay, terrorism is just for the Muslims and for the Arabs.
Mm-hmm.
If you are Arab or if you are Muslim and you have committed any crime, you are not a criminal. You are terrorist.
But okay? Amir, we actually called an American a terrorist. We had a domestic terrorism attack on our land, and that was Timothy McVeigh. So we use that term for others. May I ask you about Syria?
Yes.
When did you leave there?
Maybe 1 year. Before 1 year.
So you were there during the beginning of the Civil War?
Yes, yes. And I saw all the killing actions in my country.
And now that it's still going on a year later, what do you think?
My family house are nearly bombed.
And the fact that it still continues, what is the end? Do you see an end at all?
For the problem in Syria?
Yes.
Bashar must go out. That's the only solution. It's a freedom. It's not terrorism in Syria. It is a freedom. It is a revolution.
And so we wanted to ask you about guns. How do you feel about guns? Now, in Ohio, you have a lot of hunters in that state. Where do you live in Ohio?
Akron,
okay. So knowing that and knowing that you came from Egypt, how do you feel about guns?
Unfortunately, nowadays we have guns, but before the people don't have guns, but we have some problems in Egypt nowadays, if you follow that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, sure.
Yeah. I'm not in Egypt for this period, and it's not good thing. My husband's nephew was killed last month by the military in Egypt.
Your husband was killed?
No, my husband's nephew.
In Egypt?
Yeah.
Was he protesting?
Yeah.
Tell us what happened.
He was in Rabaa Square, and the military separate them. The military does like protesters, and they want to the people to far away from this square, and they shot randomly. When he helped someone to go to the hospital, the military killed him.
What do you think about when you hear stories about shootings in the United States or violence? What do people say, or what do you think about, you know?
It's very bad. It's very bad.